How much energy do we consume in comparison to how much energy we generate? What a question! But I have one more. Can a human produce enough electricity to power this toaster? All right, breakfast is served. Now, let's hit the power scale and make some comparisons. Human versus electric, man versus science. Maybe you tried one of these. What is our friend here doing? She's pumping away at those pedals to generate electric power. In this case, to charge her phone. Pretty cool, isn't it? Today, you can find self-charging stations like these all over the place. And this is just one of many ways to transform mechanical energy into electricity. So, you're asking, how exactly does the science work? We know the charger of a smartphone requires power, usually about 10 watts to operate. In theory, a given charger will fully recharge a battery within an hour. 10 watts times 1 hour equals 10 watt hour. So that's how much energy our friends will need to produce to charge their phones. But the first time an experiment like this was carried out, it actually involved one of these right here. The toaster challenge was famous a few years ago and is a perfect illustration of human power versus electrical power. The challenge was organized by an environmentally conscious team and stars world champion track cyclist Robert Frosterman. The experiment shows Robert on a stationary bike, and with his huge muscles, he was able to pump the pedals to generate an excess of 700 watts. And he did it while climbing a 40 degree grade. Impressive, right? His heart rate clocked at over 170 beats per minute. And after 2 minutes of all this power, out pops the piece of toast. Now, that seems a bit difficult, right? I mean, when most of us eat breakfast, we just push the toaster button and wait. But maybe we don't realize just how lucky we are to have electricity. Our toaster and many other appliances are functional thanks to the immense power supplied to your home by the power grid. But what the toaster challenge does so perfectly is get a simple message across. Even the smallest activities require a surprising amount of energy. And this is something that we take for granted every day. With all that effort, Robert was only able to generate 0.021 kilowatt hour of energy. To put things into perspective, to power a petrol car for 1 hour, we would need 180 Roberts. But hey, who needs horsepower when you got an athlete like that? Now remember, energy can never be created nor destroyed. It is simply transformed. Power generation, in essence, is the conversion of energy. For example, our bodies convert food into energy via our metabolism. That energy is used to pump up the heart, perform activities, and insulate the body. Then our muscles convert body heat into mechanical energy, like pedaling a bike, which converts that energy to something else, like racing up a mountain at high speeds, or even electricity, like heating a toaster. Oh, the power! Some cyclists can maintain 400 watts for hours. But keep in mind, these athletes have amazing abilities due to years of training. The average human, they produce around 80 to 100 watts of power when resting. But when active, we can comfortably sustain 300 to 400 watts over the period of a few minutes. In the case of short bursts of energy, some humans can output over 2000 watts. So, here is a challenge for you. Take every appliance in your home. Measure the combined wattage and, using our formula, figure out how many Roberts Fostermans you need to power your home for a day. There is plenty of fun ways to explore energy and consumption. But remember, never underestimate the power of electricity. Let's do a quick recap. Power generation comes from the transformation of energy. Electrical energy is extremely powerful and something most of us take for granted. If you're curious about the comparison, research the toaster challenge or try the nearest pedal for power station you can find. Got any more ideas? Share a comment below and don't forget to send us a like, leave a comment and subscribe. I'm Frederick. Thanks for tuning into this short episode of Ask Me What.